brothers and sisters, and welcome to St. Mary's here in Greensboro, North Carolina. In this time in which the COVID pandemic is so ravaging our nation, we continue to be people of faith and hope. We continue to reach out to those most in need with compassion and care. We are a people who still believe that the love of God can transform our hearts, to change our systems. And so we begin in the second Sunday of Advent, recognizing the call of John the Baptist, and recognizing that his call to us is one of real hope that we can become like the one in whom he proclaims in our day and in our age. And so let us begin our liturgy together. Let us begin with that hope, the love that God has, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. In today's gospel, John the Baptist calls the people to repentance so that they might prepare the way of the Lord. Knowing our own sinfulness, let us also turn our hearts to the Lord and ask for God's pardon and healing. Lord Jesus, you are the shepherd who longs to restore us to your flock. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, your patience never wavers as you tirelessly seek out the lost. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the mighty God who desires to lead us to lasting peace. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder those who set out in haste to meet your Son, but may our learning of heavenly wisdom gain us admittance to his company, lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort. Give comfort to my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her service is at an end, her guilt is expiated. Indeed, she has received from the hand of the Lord double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the desert prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the wasteland a highway for our God. Every valley shall be filled in, every mountain and hill shall be made low. The rugged land shall be made a plain, the rough country a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Go up into a high mountain, Zion, herald of glad tidings. Cry out as the top of your voice, Jerusalem, herald of good news. Fear not to cry out and say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. Here comes with the power of the Lord God, who rules by his strong arm. Here is his reward with him, his recompense before him. Like a shepherd who feeds his flock, in his arms he gathers the lambs, carrying them in his bosom and leading the ewes with care. The word of the Lord. Thanks. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. I will hear what God proclaims, the Lord, for he proclaims peace to his people. Near indeed is his salvation to those who fear him, glory dwelling in our land. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. Kindness and truth shall meet. Justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth and justice look down from heaven. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. The Lord himself will give his benefits. Our land shall yield its increase. Justice shall walk before him and prepare the way of his steps. Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. A reading from the second letter of St. Peter. Do not ignore this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord one day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years like one day. The Lord does not delay his promise, as some regard delay, but he is patient with you, not wishing that any should perish, that all should come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a mighty roar, and the elements will be dissolved by that fire, and the earth and everything done on it will be found out. Since everything is to be dissolved in this way, what sort of persons ought you to be? Conducting yourselves in holiness and devotion, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be dissolved in flames and the elements melted by fire. But according to his promise, we await new heavens and a new earth in which righteousness dwells. Therefore, beloved, since you await these things, be eager to be found without spot or blemish before him. At peace. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his paths. All flesh shall see the salvation of God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in Isaiah the prophet, behold, I am sending my messenger ahead of you. He will prepare your way. The voice of one crying out in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his paths. John the Baptist appeared in the desert, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. People of the whole Jordan, Judean countryside, and all the inhabitants of Jerusalem were going out to him and were being baptized by him in the Jordan River as they acknowledged their sins. John was clothed in camel's hair with a leather belt around his waist. He fed on locust and wild honey. And this is what he proclaimed. One mightier than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop and loosen the thongs of his sandals. I have baptized you with water. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. And the introduction which I gave for our Mass this morning is also the reality here, as it is in so many places across the United States, that the mayor of Greensboro is making the decision whether or not she will close down all of the businesses, etc., or place heavier restrictions on our movements. Now we move in this particular season of Advent, though, and recognize that there's a lot of tension, certainly in our real world, in the sense that there are a lot of tensions of all the information we have gotten, whether or not it is true or false. We move with a lot of tension between political parties and the president who does not concede the election results. We have the tensions certainly growing in our own homes and in our own lives about how to stay safe or how to exercise certain levels of freedom. How do we continue to work if we have jobs to pay bills? But there's also these tensions in our preparations for the season. And it's also choices of pathways to walk by, or the gifts that we're going to invest in. The work of transformation we will engage in, because the overall focus of the season is really to get to Bethlehem's manger. It is to present ourselves as the gift to our God, especially as Peter would say at the second coming, without stain or blemish. It's easier, as we said last week, to enter into more high-intensive labor, which can distract us, really, from the preparations for the season, rather than the silent, patient waiting to know the God who comes, because God is truly patient with us. It is easier to walk the pathways online, or to the mall, or to Santa, rather than that of the church and John the Baptist. It is easier for us to search for the perfect gift as an investment of our love and affection, rather than searching for the ways in perfecting God's gifts of love and mercy as his investment in us. It's easier to transform our lives and working space with decorations that pleases the eye than it is to transform our hearts and souls with conversion, to renew the waters of our own baptism, to know the forgiveness that really does please God. It is easier to get lost in maybe a nostalgic focus of Christmas past, rather than it is to focus on the Christmas of Christ's future coming, second coming of glory. Sometimes what we struggle with or desire right now is for that which is normal, for that which we have grown accustomed to. And yet, the season of Advent is highlighting tensions. Tensions that we can't experience directly in our own lives, but temptations that will always gloss over the message of our scriptures about the work of real conversion and reconciliation as the only gifts worthy is actually to offer Christ in the manger. It's always going to be tempting to want the privilege of baptism without the work of the Holy Spirit to help us not only turn from our sins, but to do the work and not hiding them. It will always be easier and tempting to not want John's preaching and to avoid the Jordan on the way to Bethlehem's manger in his Advent. The questions that we certainly surface at this time is, can we actually prepare to walk the season of Advent differently this year in our preparations, in our investments, in our transformations, in our own focus? So much is just challenging us with a lot of tension, with a lot of anxiety. And so we come, as I said, with real faith, real hope and real love. So can we then allow John's voice to help us cry out in our wilderness, which is going to tax our integrity? If we allow John then to teach us the humility to herald the one in whom we are to prepare the way for him to be born in us anew, if we allow him to lead us to the River Jordan to know and express our need for his preaching, for repentance, for conversion, for forgiveness, from the sins that negate the love and hope that form the wood of Bethlehem. Bethlehem's manger and Calvary's cross, we will want this advent a little differently in our preparations, in our investments, in our transformations. And we will renew within our hearts and our life, because that's what we need at this time. We need to be able to face the difficulties, the entrapments of that which is false, or the lies that we will ingest to say all is well out there. And we can say that certainly within ourselves, all is well. But if we don't focus on John's proclamation on forgiveness for the coming of Christ, can we say all is well? Because that voice is crying out in our wilderness at this time. And maybe join our voices with his to recognize how the power of God will live in the midst of all of us, in all of the storms, in all of the deceit, all of the problems that have erupted across our nation, but also across the world. We are a people of true faith, true hope, and we certainly want to engage in the love that is most authentic and true for us from our God. And we're challenged this Advent to hear that cry and to move forward as light in the midst of the darkness, preparing for the one who comes again. Amen. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us now profess our faith as we say, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things, visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us then, and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In this time of preparation and anticipation for the coming of God's kingdom in its fullness, let us come before the Lord, bringing our needs and the needs of the world. For the Pope, bishops, priests, deacons, religious, and lay ministers, may they shepherd the people of God with holiness and devotion, we pray to the Lord. For the peace of Christ to fill our hearts, our homes, our streets, our nation, our world in this Advent season, we pray to the Lord. For the healing of wounds and scars caused by racism and sexism, terrorism, supremacy, abuse and addictions, we pray to the Lord. For the many people who have died from hunger and malnutrition, from religious and political conflicts, from natural disasters and human greed, from the neglect and indifference for those suffering from the COVID-19 virus, we pray to the Lord. For all health care and many workers on the front lines during the pandemic, we pray to the Lord. For the choice of life and its preservation of it for all people born and unborn, we we pray to the Lord. For an end to families separated at our borders, for those who are trafficked, and for all peoples living in fear of those who take advantage of them, we pray to the Lord. For families in St. Mary's Parish and all families who struggle, especially those members who are unemployed, underemployed, those who wait in food lines, the lonely, and those who face chronic pain and mental illness, we pray to the Lord. For the members and friends of St. Mary's who have experienced the loss of a loved one this year, and for the intention of this Mass, may they rest with all the saints in heaven. We pray for the repose of the souls of John Stevens, requested by Dale Stevens, and Genevieve Weeks, requested by Angelina and Vanessa Steele. We pray to the Lord. In silence, please speak now your needs. We pray to the Lord. God of truth and kindness, with love and mercy you call us forward on the path of conversion. Hear our prayers, that you might answer your call with courage and with lives that proclaim your peace to all. We ask this through Christ our Emmanuel and Lord, now and forever. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, you will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings. And since we have no merits to plead our cause, come, we pray, to our rescue with the protection of your mercy. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through your goodness, we have received the bread and wine that we will offer you. And if I can get the actual preface prayer. Sorry for the confusion here, folks. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design
you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory. So without end, we acclaim, holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our Bishop, with the clergy, the religious, and the entire priestly people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Vincent de Paul, and Louise de Merrimack, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And let us join together as Jesus taught us. We dare now say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. O Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
And so may the peace of the Lord be with you always. And may we share that sign of Christ's peace with those in whom we know and those in whom need that peace of Christ in their hearts and their lives. And so the Lord's peace, Jubinyan, La Paz Contigo.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him proclaimed by John the Baptist, whose cry in the wilderness helps us to recognize the one who came to take away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you. But Lord, I am not worthy that you should come. I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. be cleansed by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly ask you, O God, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Today, the second Sunday of Advent is the memorial of St. Nicholas, Bishop and Martyr, in Smyrna of Turkey. And of course, St. Nicholas is the forerunner of Santa Claus. But in reality, Santa Claus is St. Nicholas. And in fact, there is that one song about him, Jolly Old St. Nicholas. So we take this opportunity to remember, at least on this day, the matter of gift-giving, and the gift that God truly wants from each of us is a heart that's changed and transformed by his love and his mercy. And so the Lord be with you, and may Almighty God always bless and keep you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go forth, glorifying the Lord by your lives. Thanks be to God. Thank you. Thank you, folks, and I hope that you will have a very safe and healthy week. And then all the way through the coming of these days, be open to the hope and faith and the love that you hold dear within you. And hopefully we will all come and celebrate together. Amen.